Right, good morning. I'm Bill Spadea. With you at 10 o'clock this morning. Talking Jersey, taking your calls 1-800-283-101.5. So as you know, we're here at the Garden State Film Festival, 14th annual Garden State Film Festival. They're expecting 25,000 people. I had no idea that many people come to this event. That's a huge, huge number. I am now joined by Heather O'Scanlan and Andy Peeke, two co-stars.
Hi.
House Broken, right? Good morning, guys.
House Broken.
All right. Heather, you're a little different now than I saw you like 10 minutes ago. Now, Andy, we've talked before on New Jersey 101.5.
I like to think about it more as bonded.
We did. I think you and I had an awkward moment.
You had a moment.
We had an awkward moment.
Awkward for one of us.
Yeah, true.
No, I agree.
So, Andy, you're up at 6 in the morning and you got the Ascot.
I do.
That's
what happens when
you are bringing it back or is that in?
I might bring it back. You know what? I don't follow trends.
Yeah,
I don't set trends.
He's a trendsetter.
I don't even set trends, all right? I just do what I want to do.
So tell me about
anyone.
I'm going to get Declan and ask him.
Yeah, you know, you should. That's it. That's it. Well, this is a trick husband and real husband. So you guys are
this one to Declan.
You guys are husband and wife in your movie.
Yeah.
And is this the premiere of your movie?
Max and Misty McCormick.
Yeah.
Max and Misty McCormick.
And this is the premiere
this
of
the
our
premiere?
Film. And last night was cool. It was last night we got together for the filmmakers reception here at the festival, and they showed all of the filmmakers' trailers.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you, it was neat watching our trailer in public and having other people watch it for the first time and seeing that reaction, the audience reaction.
How did they
that
react?
That was really cool. They laughed, which was
were you
the
nervous?
Idea. It was funny.
It's not like everyone's gonna publicly ridicule, was that your trailer? It was awful.
So let me ask you, how does that work? You know, you watch the movie for the first time. I imagine audiences have a real reaction.
Yeah.
Like, what happens when a movie just doesn't cut it?
Because
there's silence in the room?
Well, ask about your kids. How are your kids? Yeah.
That's the trick.
So
when
good.
They ask you that personal question, you know.
Yeah.
Those kids were really cute.
That's a good point. But it's also, you know, sometimes there's silence in the room, but there's a serious trailer. I mean, you don't want people really laughing at a serious trailer.
Yeah. Well, your movie's about
ours is about
body treatments,
right?
So does that fall into the serious category? Like, how does that work? Is that drama? Where is that? Self-help?
There are a couple punchlines thrown in there. But it's, you know, housebroken. And going number two becomes priority number one.
Wow, well, that's a good time right now. Now, when you filmed this in New Jersey, and you did it at your house.
My home,
in
yes.
How did that work out with your better half?
Well, he was out of town, so he didn't notice that there was a broken window until he got home.
I thought you pulled that skill that dug that one out of the grave once already.
Wait, another, you know, Declan O'Scanlan is here. Declan, can I just ask you real quick, just borrow your wife's mic. Was that awkward for you at all with the husband and wife team?
Well, we regularly have, you know, people in and out of the house.
So the film is Housebroken. What inspired it? Was there an inspiration on it?
Yeah, a potty training. I have a 4-year-old son.
He was
about 3 and a half and just refused to take a number two to the toilet. And just...
When Andy and I met, he had just finished that phase in his life, so it was fresh in his mind, and he had this idea for the screenplay, and he knew I was a mom, and we were relating similar stories, so it was a natural fit to write it together.
So let me ask you this, what does a film festival like this mean? We were talking about it earlier. First of all, it's in Atlantic City. Atlantic City is kind of a mess right now. I mean, it's in terms of finances, and we're going to have the mayor on later to talk about the fact that everyone in Trenton is battling back and forth over how to save Atlantic City. Here you guys are at this film festival. It's at this bright spot in the middle of all this mayhem. But what does it mean for a young actor?
Well, it's great to get the exposure, get your film out there. It's great that both New Jersey residents and our film is premiering at the Garden State Film Festival in New Jersey.
I think we're both very proud about that. It feels really good.
Yeah, it's like one step closer to digging in, Bill.
Digging in, exactly. And I know we've talked about this. And you guys are both sort of digging in.
Sort of.
unless Hollywood calls, is that how that works? Let me ask you, so what happens next? So the film premieres here, and people can actually come and see it. It's $12 a screen, as I understood it.
Yes.
Which is
probably
the cost for
a weekend pass, I think, for 40
I don't know, works. I don't know if it's one, it's
many. There are multiple options.
So what happens to the movie after this?
More festivals.
Yeah, more festivals.
Yeah, this is the first one. The next one's going to be a Take Two Film Festival in just a couple of weeks on the 22nd, I think, in New York City.
And what's the next project? Because we're always working on something. Do you have anything coming up?
I do. I have a couple things that I'm not necessarily going to go into detail, but I do have a web series I'm working on and a feature film that we're in pre-production for. So.
Okay. Now, who were the kids in the film?
They are Tallene and Ara McCumber. They are residents of Little Silver, New Jersey. And
now, are they actors? And you just kind of grab the
neighborhood
kids and like, hey, we're doing a movie. Can you come over?
It was kind of like that. Yeah, it was actually, I called some of my friends and said, hey, you know, your kids are kind of the perfect age. And we had joked at some point, the dad had done like high school theater. And I was like, what do you put your kids in a movie?
Everybody wants to be a star.
There we go.
But they were really natural on camera, and that's the Tony, our director, is like a child whisperer. She was fantastic at working with them.
Yeah, that's just great.
Yeah, so it was really, beautiful, natural.
Was it expensive to do this, or was it like you grab a camera and you're doing it on a phone and you're sitting there?
It was a professional production. You didn't pay, you know, get what you pay for. It was $20,000.
Yeah, there was a crew and a real camera. And
so do you recoup that investment?
In short film. I mean, there is some distribution for short films, but you're really not setting out to make your money back.
Well, unless you have a distribution layout.
Yeah, so really, for the most part, it's about getting yourself out there as filmmakers and actors and working with other filmmakers, and really, I think that's where the payoff is in this kind of thing.
So now, after this, and you know, what did are they here by the way? Are the kids coming?
They're coming. Yeah. They'll be here tonight. Yeah.
All right. So were they? All right. So they weren't there when they watched it for the first time.
We haven't seen. No, they've seen it, but only on like their television.
Yeah. I've only seen it looking on my laptop by myself with a password protected.
Yeah, give me a link.
Have you sat through the whole thing and then you criticize yourself as you're looking for like, oh, I could have looked better there, I could have done this.
You know what? You always do that.
Yeah.
I'm sure you don't do that with your radio show. You listen to it, you're like, I'm perfect, I'm on point, everything I'm saying is great.
See, and you know me. That's it. Actually, I forget what I say after I'm done. Yeah. So the minute I walk, I have no idea.
But you remember our handshake, though.
Well, I remember the awkward moments. I remember. And I should bring that up again. Yeah, second time.
You remember talking about it.
I do. Some things I do. But like, do you sit and you watch it and you critique it? And will you watch it several times? Like, you go home tonight, you're like, pull up the link and watch it again.
I'll watch it. And
I think that's the battery now.
I'll watch it once or twice. And that was good. I felt good about it. And we're back to being a couple now. What do you think, honey?
I'm feeling a little smooshy.
So let me ask you, and just real quick, we talked about the bedroom scene.
Yeah.
It was a bedroom scene anyway. But it was not inappropriate.
We both had crusty pajamas on and a kid coming in.
Yeah, see, that was giving that look like, poopies. You know.
I got poopies in my pants.
Wow. Okay. You were, I saw that in the trailer, you're facing away from each other.
Yes.
You guys like each other a little more than that.
In real life.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So the film, now Declan's looking, he's giving me that look like, come on.
The battery died.
I haven't put them a little bit closer together. All right. So the film is Housebroken. And it's about a 4-year-old who's learning to potty train.
Yeah.
You guys are husband and wife. It premieres here tonight at Grunt State Film
Block. Tomorrow night, 5:30.
Tomorrow night.
At the 5:30 film block.
Okay. You guys excited?
Oh, very good. What's that like? 35 hours from now, right?
35 hours from now.
Countdown.
It's it. That's it. All right. Heather O'Scanlan, Andy Peeke. Guys, thank you for coming on the show. 1.5. You guys are great. Good luck with the movie. Always good to see you.
Shake my hand. Things are getting weird in here.
You never know what to expect at the Garden State Film Festival. 646 on New Jersey 101.5. Traffic weather next.